All right, so I'm gonna keep it a band with y'all. Now, this video is not a direct shot at Scott O'Gallagher. I actually think it is huge news that he is coming to EA. But this is to talk about EA Sports themselves. And the question that I want all of y'all to answer right now, ask yourself this: can y'all trust EA? Especially with the NBA Live franchise, can y'all trust EA? Think about their history, not even just the recent history, but think about from NBA Live 10 to now. Do you think with their history with the franchise, do you think you can honestly sit down and say, I could trust EA right now? Because that's what goes through my mind when I see people assuming that Scott O'Gallagher is back for NBA Live. Y'all are assuming that he is back for NBA Live. He didn't even say himself that he's back for NBA Live or a basketball game, period. How do y'all know if he's there for Live or not? EA could assign him to Madden, like how they did a few of NBA Live devs. They assigned them to Madden. So y'all just assuming that he's there for Live. Now, I get it. You know, I know Scott history. He worked on Live 14, and then he left, and then he went to 2K and all the other stuff. I know his history. But what I am saying to you is, looking at from how they handled the NBA Live series, can you say straight up and down, Scott is back for NBA Live? You can't say that, because he didn't even say he's back for NBA Live. He just said he's a creative director for EA Sports. That could mean a lot of things, and he could be that for a lot of games. He could bring that aspect to Madden, because if you look at the YAR, that's like what I believe the YAR is like it's supposed to be like NFL Street or something. So he could be a creative director for that mode, you know? Like, I'm not coming on here trying to poop on nobody's dream. I just want to, you know, take all of that false hope out of your minds. Let's be real. You cannot predict somebody that is unpredictable. We have to be real here. Look at the last past 5 years that EA has been handling NBA Live. Look at Live 16 to now. They already had 2 cancellations. Matter of fact, if you want to be technical, that's 3. So out of the 5 years that you had NBA Live, only what 3 games been released? 2 games. Well, 3 games if it's from Live 16 until now. So that's 3 games. 3 games, right? And 3 of those games were also canceled in the last past 5 years. So you put out 6 games in total, and 3 of those games did not release. Do y'all see where I'm going with this? How can you trust EA with their history? Let's keep it a band right here. Can you trust EA with Scott? Now, we all know it's the same story with EA and these devs for NBA Live. All of them leave. Look at Mike Wang. He left. Look at Scott. Scott left. Look at all of these devs that left. And every single one of them says the exact same thing. They all left because EA does not give them creative control over the game. That's why every single one of them left. That's why every single one of them left. That's why Mike Wang left and went to 2K. That's why Scott OG left and went to 2K. Because they give him creative control over there. And speaking of 2K, you want to keep it real? A lot of y'all hate on 2K. But if you want to keep it real, 100% real, 2K is NBA Live. If you want to be real, 2K is what NBA Live would have been if EA would have actually gave their devs creative control. If you want to be real. 2K isn't bail off. Because before 2K took over, it was in bail off. It was just straight in bail off. There was no competition with 2K. 2K was far behind in bail off. But since EA started doing some crazy stuff and not producing games, all the other stuff, 2K took over because of Mike Wang. So hate on 2K as much as you want, but just know you're playing a prototype of NBA Live. I hope y'all really know that. I hope y'all know y'all are playing a prototype of NBA Live with Mike Wang and all that stuff. Mike Wang, I believe Mike Wang was the gameplay. I'm pretty sure Mike Wang did the gameplay over on NBA Live as well, if I'm not mistaken. But if he did, y'all are playing NBA Live. When you talk about the gameplay, that is NBA Live. Mike Wang is bringing that. And that's what they lost. Still on top of that, look at their history again. They have a huge, the inconsistency with NBA Live is astounding, bro. It just amazes me. So they have a long list of games being not finished and cancellations. That's been the story in the last past 10 years for NBA Live, bro. The last decade, they have released games that was either unfinished or was canceled completely. That's why I like, yo, if I'm EA, I'm going to rebrand NBA Live. By the way, if you're going to rebrand NBA Live, do not call it NBA Elite. Don't ever use Elite ever again. I never played NBA Live before 18. And I already hear bad stories about Elite and how bad that game was. Even the real fanboys even said NBA Live Elite was garbage. So again, if you plan on rebranding NBA Live, don't use Elite. Don't use NBA Elite. If it says Elite on it, I'm not buying it. I promise you that. You would not see a NBA Elite 22 on my as my content. You will not see that on my channel. No sir, I refuse that. At the end of the day, I just don't want y'all to get y'all hopes up, because at the end of the day, EA is gonna do what EA do, and us as a consumer, we're going to make that decision to either buy the game or not buy the game. So you know, as we all are hoping for another NBA Live, we can't force them to give us an NBA Live either. They have to just, it's like this. EA either have to want to give us a NBA Live or they don't. And if they don't, hey, it is what it is. You know, like there's other games out there to play. It don't have to be 2K, but if you are a sports fan, you know, that's the only option. Me as a gamer, I'm not gonna just stick to 2K. I play 2K, but I don't play it like, you know, in a competitive sense, you know. So there's other games for us to play out there. We just can't dwell on NBA Live. Like I said, EA have to want it, and if they don't, we can't force them either. You know, so it is what it is, man. But I'm gonna get up out of here. If y'all enjoyed this video, make sure you hit the like button, comment, and if you are new, subscribe. Of course, that goes a long way. And click that bell and make sure the bell is turned on to all, so you can get all of my notifications anytime I stream, anytime I post a video, anything of that nature. And it's your boy River Brent. Love you guys, and I see y'all in the next video or stream, whichever one it is. Peace. The best song is probably on the B-side. Won't be surprised when the label denied the secret. The best song is probably on the demo, but that's not the one that got you your limo, limousine.